Hello, everyone, and welcome to the show. My name is Ian Hansen.
And I'm Raya Khan.
We are the directors of the Orwell cast.
Our cast has been working really hard for the past month to bring this show to life, and we really hope that you enjoy the show as much as we have enjoyed working with this such a talented and hardworking group of actors.
Feel free to comment your appreciation for the show when we open the chat at the end of the performance. The recording of the performance will be available after the if you'd like to save it and rewatch it, or send it to any friends and relatives who weren't able to make it to the live show.
You can also find more information about the show and Spotlight Theater in the playbill linked below, as well as our website, including information on how to contact us and sign up for our upcoming fall show.
If you have the means, please consider donating to the program and into the chapter. Donations will be held through the Brookline FABA, French Performing Arts, and will be going towards our props, costumes, and set fund. We love what we do, and we greatly appreciate any donations to help make Spotlight Theater a permanent part of the Brookline community.
And now, without further ado, please enjoy Matilda.
In one way or another, every human being is unique, for better or for worse. Most parents believe their children are the most beautiful creatures to ever grace the planet. Others take a less emotional approach.
Children, what a waste of time.
Too painful.
And expensive.
Harry and Xenia Wormwood lived in a very nice neighborhood, in a very nice house. But they were not really very nice people. The Wormwoods were so wrapped up in their own silly lives that they barely even noticed they had a daughter. If they paid any attention to her at all, they would have realized she was a rather extraordinary child.
Oh my gosh! Harry! Look at what she did! She spit all over me, that little brat!
By the time she was two, Matilda had learned what most people learn in their early 30s, how to take care of herself. Every morning, Matilda's older brother, Michael, would go to school. Matilda's father went to work, selling used cars for unfair prices, and Matilda's mother took off to play bingo.
Soup's on the stove. Heat up if you get hungry.
Matilda was left alone, which was exactly the way she liked it.
All alone am I ever since...
A book? What do you want a book for?
To read.
By the time she was four, Matilda had read every book in the house. One night, she got the courage to ask her father something she desperately wanted.
To read? Why would you want to read when you have the television set right in front of you? There's nothing you can get from a book that you can't get from a television faster.
That is certainly not true.
Don't be stupid. Just sit down and watch TV like the rest of us.
The next morning, after Matilda's parents left, Matilda went off in search of a book.
Where are the children's books, please?
Right over there. Would you like me to pick one out for you with lots of pictures in it?
No, thank you. I'm sure I can manage.
You know, you can have your very own library card, and then you can take books home, and then you won't have to walk here every day. You can take with you as many as you like.
That would be wonderful.
So Matilda's strong young mind continued to grow, nurtured by all the voices of the books that she read. These books gave Matilda a hopeful and comforting message. You are not alone.
You are not alone.
Did this come today? Where'd all this come from?
Library.
The library? You've never set foot in a library. You're only 4 years old.
Six and a half.
You're four.
Six and a half.
If you were six and a half, you'd be in school already.
I told you I was supposed to be in school. I want to be in school. You wouldn't listen.
School? It's out of the question. Who would be here to sign for the packages? We can't just leave good packages sitting out on the doorstep. Now go watch TV like a good kid.
You know, sometimes I wonder what's wrong with that girl.
Tell me about it.
Hey, stupid, have another marshmallow. Stupid.
Sometimes Matilda longed for a friend, someone like the kind, courageous people in her books. It occurred to her that, like talking dragons and princesses with hair long enough to climb, such people might only exist in storybooks. But she was about to find out that she could be her own friend, that she had a type of strength that she wasn't even aware of. What doesn't kill you
makes you stronger. Great, I'm incredible. Michael, pencil and paper, in the kitchen.
Did we sell some cars today?
Did we?
Does that mean we can get a new TV set?
Son, it's time I taught you the family business. Sit down, write this down. All right, the first car that your brilliant father sold cost $320. I sold it for $1,158. The second one cost $512. I sold it for $2,269.
Wait, Dad, can you repeat that first one?
Just right. The third one cost $68. I sold it for $999. And the fourth cost $1,100. And I sold it for $7,839. What was my profit for the day?
Give me another minute.
10,265. Check it if you don't believe me.
You're a little cheap. You saw the paper.
From all the way over here?
Are you being smart with me? If you're being smart with me, young lady, then you are going to be punished.
Punished for being smart?
When a person is bad, that person has to be taught a lesson.
With that, Harry Wormwood had unintentionally given his daughter the first practical advice she could use, that children could punish their parents. Only when they deserved it, of course. Money, money, money.
Must be fun. Michael, come into my room.
What?
It's time I took you to the shop. What do you say?
I don't know. What do you say, Dad?
I say that appearance is 9/10 of the law, which is why I take such good care of myself. Well-oiled hair, clean-shaven, snappy suit. Now run along and get ready for a big day of learning, kid. There's a sucker born every minute, and we're going to take them for all they've got.
Dirty dealings like buying stolen car parts never stay secret for long, especially when the FBI gets involved.
Harry Wormwood.
No kidding, this guy again?
Huh. Are you really that surprised?
Well, what do you think? It's only 9:17.
It's 9:18. Sam, this is the third time this week. I really think you should get that watch fixed.
Third time this week?
Huh. Hey!
Good one. I get it.
Sam, this is serious. We could get evidence that could bust this guy any second.
Any second now?
Yes. Now shut up and watch.
Watch?
Get it together, Sam.
Get it together.
Dad.
What? Yeah, what do you want?
What's 12 times 12?
I don't know. Who do you think I am? Albert Einstein?
144.
What's 13 times 4?
Why don't you just use the calculator?
You took out the batteries for the TV remote.
52?
What about 52 times 4?
Stop that! Do you think you're smarter than me? get this into your head. I'm smart, you're dumb. I'm big, you're little. I'm right, you're wrong. And there's nothing you can do about it.
Harry! Harry! I won! I won the double bingo! Come on, everyone! We're going out for dinner tonight!
Let me see the money.
Harry! Your hair looks awful. I hope they let you in.
They'll let me in.
Here's your hat, Dad.
Thanks. In the car. Now, how much money?
You know, it's nice to go out sometimes. You never take us out!
What do you mean? Of course I do.
Bonjour. This way, please.
Harry, take your hat off. This is a nice place.
Hi, my name is Avery. I'll be your waiter tonight. Can I set you off with anything to drink?
Can't take it off.
Harry, no one cares what your stupid hair looks like.
It won't come off.
Why won't this hat come off?
Pull it. Pull it.
Can I get a lemonade, please?
Pull it.
Here you go. Anything else?
Harry, I still don't understand how you glued your hand onto your head. I mean, you told me you didn't, but you obviously did.
I did not glue my hat to my head. You know what? From now on, this family does exactly what I say, exactly when I say it. And right now, we are eating dinner and watching TV.
Look, it's starting.
Welcome to Dancing Lyrics. For those idiots out there, you don't know how to play, here's how it goes. I'll play some song lyrics. You finish those song lyrics. For each answer our contestants get correct, they'll move closer to the final challenge, the dance battle. Everyone will dance, and the winner gets the big cash prize.
What do you want? And what is this trash you're reading?
It's not trash. It's lovely. It's called Moby Dick. It's by Herman Melville.
Moby what? This is filth!
Fine. It's a library book. You can't...
I'm fed up with all this reading. You're a wormwood, so start acting like one. Sit up and watch the TV. We've already missed the first round, and it's all your fault, you little brat.
We're down to our last four competitors, Jill, Ryan, Susan, and Patricia. Now then, finish these lyrics. The snow goes white on the mountain at night, no footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolations, and it looks like... Yes, Ryan?
And it looks like I want to scream!
Wrong!
Looks like something unforeseen.
What? No!
And it looks like I'm a queen.
So close, but no.
The queen!
Ding, ding, ding! Susan and Patricia move on to the final round. It's time to dance for your lives.
They say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead while I was passing by. And now I beg to see you dance just one more time. Ooh, I see you, see you, see you every time. And oh my, I like your style. You make me wanna try. And now I beg to see you dance just one more time. So I say, dance for me, dance for me, dance for me, oh, oh. Anybody do the things you do before? They say, move for me, move for me, move for me, hey, hey. And when you're done,
what an amazing dance battle! And now, the winner is
Tilda.
I didn't do anything. I think.
Of course you did.
The TV set!
Harry, I told you that TV was too cheap!
It's not cheap, it's stolen.
Magic or coincidence? She didn't know. It is said that we humans only use a tiny portion of our brains in our everyday lives. If it weren't for the events that began the very next day, Matilda might never have found her great strength of mind.
Call it magic.
I need a car, inexpensive but reliable. Can you service me?
In a manner of speaking, yes. Welcome to Wormwood Motors. Harry Wormwood, owner, founder, whatever.
Agatha Trunchbull, principal of Cruncham Hall Elementary School. I warn you, sir, I am not one to fall for any tricks.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
My school is a model of discipline. Use the rod. That's my motto.
Excellent motto.
Do you have any brats yourself?
Well, I got a boy, Mikey, and one mistake, Matilda.
Ugh, they're all mistakes, children. Filthy, nasty things of blood. I was never one.
Well, since you're an educator, I'm going to make you a great deal.
You'd better.
Let's do business.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living.
Hey, you. You're going to school.
I am?
First thing tomorrow. Yeah. You'll get a real education at this place.
Matilda had always wanted to go to school because she loved to learn. She tried to imagine what her new school would be like. She pictured a lovely building surrounded by trees, flowers, and swings, with lots of other children to play with. Well, there was a building and children, so regardless of what Cruncham Hall looked like, she was happy to be there. After all, any school is better than no school at all.
And heads up, shoulders back, stomachs in, and stand up straight.
Hi, my name is Matilda.
To hear you, my name's Eva.
Is that our teacher?
Is that? No, that's the principal, Miss Trunchbull. I'm Lavender.
She make every lesson to every classroom to show the teachers are handing kids or think or two about handing kids.
But I thought she was a principal. Principals don't do lessons, right?
She makes a lesson during She just missed Trunchbull's weekly lessons.
Okay. So,
better than being put in a choke.
What's the chokey?
Chokey is a tall, narrow hole in a well behind the door. You have to stand in the droopy pipes with jagged edges.
She puts kids in there?
I've been there twice. She sometimes leaves you there all day. You know, yesterday this one kid ate two M&Ms during his Trunchbull's weekly lesson.
Did Miss Trunchbull catch the kid?
Worse.
Was he okay?
After being thrown out of the window, of course he wasn't okay. He lived it, that's what you mean. You know, she used to be in the Olympics, you know, javelin?
Here she comes!
Ava? What are those?
What was, Miss Trunchbull?
Hanging by your ears.
You mean my pigtails?
Are you a pig, Ava?
No, Miss Trunchbull.
And do I allow pigs at my school?
My mommy thinks they're sweet.
Ugh, judging from her choice of husband, your mommy has no taste at all. You'll chop those off of your school tomorrow.
But I...
Did you just say but to me?
Uh-oh. Good loft. Excellent release. Think she's going to make the fence? Going to be close one. Going, gone.
Quiet! All of you! Go to class before I throw you all in the chokey!
Tilda's teacher, Miss Honey, was one of the most kind-hearted and remarkable people.
Welcome back, Ava. Okay, listen up, everyone. We have a new student with us today. This is Matilda Wormwood. Matilda, I'd like you to sit over here with Lavender. Now, you all remember how scary your first days at school were, so I'd like you to be especially nice to Matilda and make her feel welcome.
Miss Honey was a wonderful teacher and a friend to everyone, but her life was not as beautiful and simple as it seemed. She had a deep, dark secret, and though it caused her great pain, she didn't let it interfere with her teaching.
Well, Matilda, you've come on a very good day because we're going to review everything we've learned so far. Now, it's all right if you don't understand any of this because you're brand new, but if you don't know, do not answer, just raise your hand. Let's do some practice problems together. Write the answers on your paper. 2 times 4 is? 2 times 6 is? 2 times 9 is? Excellent, you've been practicing. Pretty soon you'll be able to do any multiplication, whether it's 2 times 7, very good, at 13 times 379.
Four thousand six hundred and 25.
I beg your pardon?
I think that's the answer. 4, 9, 2, 5.
It is! Matilda, you know how to multiply large numbers?
I read this book last year in mathematics at the library.
You like to read?
I love to read.
What do you like to read?
Well, everything. But lately I've been reading Charles Dickens. I could read him every day.
So could I. All right, everyone, take out your workbooks. Let's start with section 3. I'll be back in a moment.
Hey! Come in, whoever you are. Oh, good to see you. Time for one of our little hot-to-hots.
Actually, it's about the new girl in my class, Miss Trunchbull, Matilda Wormwood.
Her father says she's an awful child.
No, Matilda Wormwood is a very sweet girl and very bright.
Huh! A bright child!
Yes, she can multiply large numbers in her head.
So can a calculator!
Well, I think she might be happier in an older and more advanced class.
Listen to me, Jenny. The distance the javelin goes depends upon the effort you put into it. Perspiration! If you can't handle the little brat, I'll lock her up in the chokey. Get it? One day, Jen, you'll see everything I do is for your own good. And those putrid little children!
home?
How was school?
School was great. Look, my teacher lets me do sixth grade work, algebra and geometry.
You're kidding. Matilda, can't you stay in the middle of an important phone call?
Like, you just asked me how school was.
As I was saying, I'm sorry.
Well, it was really great.
Really?
The principal is insane. She threw a girl with a fence by her hair. And I had the most wonderful teacher.
Mine is driving me crazy. I'm telling you, 6 hours of school is not enough.
I'll say.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Bye. Yeah, bye. Oh, you're home. Who made dinner?
Hello.
We don't give money, we don't like charities, we will buy raffle tickets, though.
Mr. Wormwood, I'm Jennifer Honey. I'm Matilda's teacher.
What has she done now? Look,
no, there's no problem.
Then scram, I'm watching TV. All right, come in, whatever. Zinnia!
Who is it?
Some teacher says she's got to talk to you about Matilda.
I'm sure you're aware by now that Matilda has a very brilliant mind.
Of course, totally. Michael, get me a Pop-Tart.
Her math skills are simply extraordinary.
You want a Pop-Tart?
No, thank you, dear. I really feel with private instructions that she'd be ready for college in just a few short years.
College? I didn't go to college. I don't know anyone who did.
Look, a girl doesn't get anywhere by acting intelligent. I mean, look at you and me. You chose books, I chose looks. I have a wonderful house, a wonderful husband, and you are teaching snot-nosed children or ABCs.
Don't sneer at educated people, Mrs. Wormwood. If you became ill, heaven forbid, your doctor would have been a college graduate. Or say you were sued for selling a faulty car, Mr. Wormwood. The lawyer who defended you would have been a college graduate, too.
Which car? Who have you been talking to?
Oh, dear. I can see we're not going to agree here, are we? I'm sorry I burst in on you like this.
We are. Sue her for interrupting our show.
When I get a degree, I will make a bigger salary.
Okay, let's go through our aliases one more time.
Okay, got it.
This time, no note cards.
Chill out. Don't stress, man. I've got this.
Okay. My name is Jason. I'm a speedboat salesman who recently moved to town. I have a wife and two kids, ages 8 and 12. Your turn.
What?
Your turn.
You lied to me?
What?
This whole time, you haven't been an undercover agent for the FBI. You're married. You even sell speedboats anymore.
Sam, we've been over this. It's an alias, which means...
Which means it's not true.
Good. Now, your turn. What's your name?
Sam.
No, it's Tony.
No, it's Sam. I'm an undercover agent for the FBI.
I am Jason. You are Tony, my coworker in the speedboat industry.
I am? Who even am I anymore?
Tony.
Okay, Tony. My name's Sam.
Get it together, Sam.
The cops are watching her house.
What? Oh, those are speedboat salesmen. Really nice guys.
Speedboats? There are no lakes around here.
Yeah, but some people like to go away on the weekends. Some people like to have fun.
And some people are cops.
They are not cops.
Are too.
They are not. I ought to know if the cops are watching my house. Now go to your room.
With the FBI watching her father and the Trunchbull terrorizing her school, it was a rare and happy moment when Matilda could just play outside with her friends.
Look.
What is it?
I'm not sure. A salamander? A chameleon?
Come inside. Come inside quickly. Miss Trunchbull is teaching our class today. Ava, please get a water pitcher. We need to be prepared in case she gets thirsty.
Hey, Miss Sunny.
Oh, yeah. Make sure the water is cold. Lavender. Put away anything colorful. Hurry! Now, don't speak unless you are spoken to. Don't laugh. Don't smile. Don't even breathe loudly.
Don't breathe at all!
Good morning, Miss Trunchbull.
I've never been able to understand why small children are so disgusting. They're like insects. They should be gotten rid of as early as possible. My idea of a perfect school is one where there are no children. Do you agree, Miss Honey?
Does anyone want to tell Miss Trunchbull about what we learned to spell today?
Miss Honey teach us many things. We can spell difficulty.
Shut it! You couldn't even spell difficulty if your life depended on me. Someone get me some water. All this talking is making me thirsty.
Is your water, Miss Trunchbull?
It's a snake! It's a snake! What if you tried to poison me? Who was it? Matilda! I knew it!
I just thought you'd like to know it's not a snake, it's a newt.
What did you say?
It's a newt, Miss Trunchbull.
Stand up, you villainous child! You did this!
No, Miss Trunchbull.
Did you act alone or did you have accomplices?
I'm telling you, I didn't do it!
Even if you didn't do it, I'm going to punish you because I am big, you are small. I'm right, and you're wrong, and there's nothing you can do about it! You!
I didn't move!
You did this!
How could she possibly have done it if she was sitting way over there?
I will be watching you, each and every one of you. When you turn the corner, when you go to your little cubbies to get your disgusting coats, when you skip merrily to lunch, I will be watching you, and especially you!
Everyone, go outside. I'll come out in a minute and help fill the bird feeder, okay? I'll be out in a minute.
Miss Honey, I did it.
Did what?
I made the glass tip over.
Oh, sweetheart, don't let Miss Trunchbull make you feel that way. Nobody did it. It was an accident.
I did with my eyes. Watch, I'll prove it to you.
It's wonderful you feel so powerful, Matilda. No, some people don't feel powerful at all.
Come on, Glass. Tip over.
It's all right, Matilda.
I really did it, Miss Honey.
One of the odd things about life is sometimes you can do something until you want to show someone, and then you can't.
This isn't like that. I don't know. Maybe I'm just tired. Do you believe me, Miss Honey, about the glass tipping over?
I believe that you should believe in whatever power you think you have inside of you. Believe it with all your heart. You know, there was this girl I used to know who lived on the furthest hill in town. Do you know where that hill is, Matilda?
Yes.
The girl's life was good and happy. When she was just 2 years old, her mother died. Her father was a doctor, so he needed someone to look after things at home. So he invited the mother's evil stepsister. The mother's stepsister treated the girl very badly.
The Trunchbull.
Yes, and worst of all, when the girl was 5, her father died. But the ending of the story is a bit happier. The girl found a small cottage and moved out of her wicked aunt's house. Do you know why I'm telling you this?
No.
You were born into a family that doesn't always appreciate you, but one day things are going to be very different.
You're very brave, Miss Honey.
Not as brave as you.
Let's go get your treasures then. You must have had something that you want to get.
Photographs of my mother and father, and a beautiful doll my mother gave me, my Lissy doll.
Well, let's go get them.
No, Matilda.
After school?
I'll think about it. How about that?
She shouldn't be allowed to treat people that way. We'll wait until she leaves. We'll go to her house, and then we can go get your doll.
Matilda, promise me you'll never go into that house, ever.
So, one day, Harry came home with $2,000 cash and threw it up in the air. We both danced and danced like we were on the dancing lyrics. Do you like that show?
Oh, I love that show.
That was the old days. Now we have money in banks all over this planet. And does he give me a dime? Matilda! This is Jason and this is Tony. They're speedboat salesmen. They're speedboat salesmen!
Cops? You said anything about cops?
Anywho. Hi, Matilda. I'm Jason.
Hi, I'm Tony.
Yes. Tony.
Tony. Age, late 20s. Profession, not cop. Sales of boats of speed. Ha, 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 ha.
Zinnia, honey, I'm starving. Wait, who are you? What is this, some kind of hot tub party? Get out of here, now!
They're cops, Dad.
Here.
Why did you do that? You don't let me talk to anybody anymore. I need to talk to somebody else, Harry. I'm suffocating. I don't want to talk to our stupid kids.
Dad,
what do you want?
Yell at me, okay?
Shut up and leave us alone.
Yell at me again.
Yell at you? What do I need to do to gain respect around here? My word is my law. You understand? Law.
No kid likes being yelled at. But with precisely Harry's ranting and raving, they gave Matilda the key to her power. To unlock that power, all she had to do was practice.
You're a little cheap. I'm smart, you're dumb. I'm big, you're little. I'm right, you're wrong. What don't you understand? Don't you slam the door at me!
Having power isn't nearly as important as what you choose to do with it. And what Matilda had in mind was nothing short of heroic. I'm sorry, Miss Honey. I know you told me never to come here. But I have to get you that doll. All right, focus. Come on, Lissy doll. Where are you? Where are you? Come on. Come on, Lissy. Come on. Yes! Miss Honey! Look what I got you! Oh, I also brought you this. I ate mine last night.
I will be teaching your class today.
The time it took Miss Honey to get very, very nervous, Matilda had formulated a plan. Miss Honey, I don't think that your father's death was an accident. If you could tell me a few things about him, maybe I could.
Matilda, hurry to your seat. She's getting mad.
What's his name?
Miss Trunchbull, Matilda and I will just be a second. Magnus, and he used to call me his bumblebee. I'm sure she knows the doll is missing by now.
And he calls her Miss Trunchbull?
No, I suppose he called her Agatha.
Okay. Agatha. Okay, no. Don't worry, Miss Honey. I've got this.
I could go back to the house after school and put the doll back.
No, Miss Honey, really. I promise. I have a plan.
Jenny! Matilda! Classroom now! Now, children, do you know it was illegal to enter someone's home without their permission?
Yes, Miss Trunchbull.
Now, let's play a little game, shall we? I know one of you disgusting creatures snuck into my home. Who was it?
Miss Trunchbull, I was the one at your house last night.
Jenny! You will never see the light of day ever again!
I'm not a 7-year-old anymore, Aunt Trunchbull.
Shut up!
Look, the chalk.
So, this is Matt. Give my little bumblebee back. And get out of town. If you don't, I will get you like you got me. That is a promise.
Honey moved back into her father's house. Of course, Matilda was a frequent visitor.
Did you know that the heart of a mouse beats at a rate of 650 times a minute?
My, where did you learn that?
In a book. It doesn't sound like it's beating at all. It sounds like it's humming. The heart of a porcupine beats at a rate of 300 times a minute.
Hurry up! Get in! Let's go! Matilda, get in the car now!
I'd be happy to walk her home.
No, we'll be there when you get there. We're moving to Bermuda! Let's go!
Bermuda?
Yes, Harry's not working on the autos business anymore. Let's go!
Get in the car, Melinda.
Tilda.
Whatever, we got to beat those speedboat salesmen to the airport.
Isn't fair. I love it here. I love my school. I want to stay with Miss Honey.
Miss Honey doesn't want you. Why would she want some snotty, disobedient kid?
Because she's a spectacularly wonderful child, and I love her.
Not me, Miss Honey. Adopting. Hold on, one sec. I have these adoption papers.
What? Where did you get those?
Library. What are you supposed to do with some of them?
Well, I'll be an only child again.
Stop.
Tilda, you're the only daughter I've ever had. And I never understood you. Not one little bit. Who's got a pen?
Doing perhaps the first thing they ever did for their daughter, the Wormwood signed the adoption papers.
You won't be calling us for, like, sport payments or something, will you?
Oh, no. Oh, no. We'll have everything we need.
Harry, Zinnia, and Michael got away. And as bad as things were before, that's how good they became. Miss Honey was made principal of Crunchham Hall, which had to add an upper class because children never wanted to leave. And Matilda found, to her great surprise, that life could be fun, and she decided to have as much of it as possible. After all, she was a very smart kid. But the happiest part of the story was that Matilda and Miss Honey each both got what they always wanted, a loving family.
Oh, I would like to reach out my hand. Oh, Miss Sayo, oh, may tell you to run. Nobody say, nobody young.